Hi everyone! In today's video, I'll show you how to transform your Excel inventory data into this insightful and interactive Power BI dashboard. Let's start with an overview of the inventory dashboard, beginning with the aging dashboard view. At the top, you'll see two buttons, aging and stock. A gray line below the aging button indicates that we're currently in the aging view. In this view, the inventory is categorized into age groups, 1 to 3 months, 4 to 6 months, 7 to 9 months, 10 to 12 months, and beyond 12 months. Displaying inventory quantity by age groups helps you easily identify slow-moving stock and focus on items that might need attention. On the left side, we have three pie charts, each representing a different storage location. The number in the center of each pie chart shows the total inventory for that location, while the segments show the breakdown by inventory age. This allows you to quickly compare the distribution of stock at each location. Next to the pie charts is a decomposition chart. This chart displays the total inventory on the left and lets you drill down by age group, location, brand, product group, and specific products. It's a powerful way to uncover deeper insights into your stock distribution and inventory performance. At the top right, you'll find buttons labeled quantity and value. Click on value if you want to view the dashboard by the value of inventory instead of quantity, and the entire dashboard updates instantly. You can also click on any part of the pie charts to filter the entire dashboard based on that selection. To switch to the stock view, just click on the stock button at the top, and the dashboard will smoothly transition to display the stock information. Now, let's explore the stock dashboard view. This view provides a comprehensive overview of your stock status, helping you manage restocking efficiently. In the top right corner, you can see the total inventory quantity. To the left, there are four drop-down lists that let you filter data by location, brand, product group, and product. I'll show you how these filters work in a moment. Next to the filters is a line chart that displays the monthly sales trend over the past 12 months, helping you quickly assess sales performance and identify trends. At the bottom left, there's a tree map that visualizes the inventory breakdown based on the selected filter. You can view breakdowns by location, brand, product group, or even by aging, making it easy to pinpoint where most of your stock is concentrated. To the right of the tree map, you'll find a table that provides a detailed view of individual products. It includes information like quantity on hand, stock status whether it's below safety stock, above safety stock, or above reordering point, next order delivery date and quantity, as well as average daily sales quantity. Now, let's see how easy it is to use this dashboard. For example, let's filter for a specific location. By selecting apses from the location dropdown, the entire dashboard refreshes to display data for apses only. Next, let's filter further by selecting the brand Calis. Notice how the dashboard instantly updates to show data for the apses location and the Calis brand. We can drill down even further by selecting Juicer from the product dropdown to see the status of each product under the Calis brand at apses Logistics. If we change the tree map breakdown to show inventory by aging, you'll see a detailed view of the age distribution of the stock. From the stock table, you can even click on any product to see its inventory age and past 12 months sales trend, giving you insights into stock performance and stock turnover. This dashboard is designed to help you track inventory levels, monitor stock aging, and manage your inventory across various storage locations, all in just a few simple steps. If you like what you're seeing so far, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Now, let me show you how to make this dashboard yours in three simple steps. Step 1. Download the template. Start by downloading the Power BI template and the Excel dataset using the link in the description below. It's completely free and easy to access. After downloading, extract the files from the zip folder, and you're done with step 1. Step 2. Replace the dataset. Before diving into the Excel dataset, let's briefly go over the data structure. The dataset contains four tables. The main stock table includes stock data, such as purchase ID, location, product ID, order date, delivery date, order quantity, stock balance, and stock value. The sales table contains the sales date, product ID, and the sales quantity at each location, enabling the dashboard to calculate safety stock and reorder points. The new table holds information about upcoming purchase orders, while the product table lists product details like product name, group, and brand. These tables are linked via key fields, enabling the dashboard to offer comprehensive insights. Now, let's open the Excel file. In the stock worksheet, replace the sample inventory data with your own details. In the sales worksheet, replace the sample data with your own sales records, including the sales date, product ID, sales quantity at each location, and total sales quantity. For the new worksheet, enter your upcoming purchase order data. Finally, update the product worksheet with product information specific to your organization, and that's it for the Excel file setup. Step 3. Load your data to the BI template. Open the BI file in the Power BI desktop. If you don't have Power BI desktop yet, download it free from the Microsoft website. The link is in the description. For those interested in creating the entire dashboard, I have a time-lapse video that walks you through the process. Click the link above to watch. Now, to replace the data file in Power BI, click on the Transform Data button to enter the query view. To adjust the data source settings, click on the Data Source Settings button at the top. Select the file shown, then click on Change Source. Browse and navigate to the folder where you saved your dataset, and the BI file will automatically update with the new data. To exit query view and load your data, go to the top left corner and click Close and Apply. Give it some time to load your new data. And there you have it! By following these simple steps, you'll have a fully functional inventory dashboard to help streamline your stock management and data analysis. Going forward, you just need to update the Excel worksheet and click the Refresh button at the top to update the dashboard with the latest data. I hope you find this inventory dashboard template helpful for your work or learning. If you are looking for more dashboard templates, be sure to check out my earlier videos. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one.